What's up, everyone? Poison here, and this isn't our post-commentary. This is for Payday 2. Now, there's a reason I didn't do this one live. Reason number one is I recorded during the day when we were... Well, when everyone was home and doing stuff, so... There was a vacuum running, a blender, so I couldn't really record or be a lot of noise. Secondly, this video, I plan on doing post-commentary. So, the first Payday 2 video I upload was actually, me stealthing this mission. Now, in Payday, there's two options. There's stealth, and then there's, going loud. Last time I did stealth, I did not plan to go stealth. That was just pure luck. So, I was amazed. I'm like, oh my god, I actually did it. That was, like, the second mission I ever stealthed. Goddamn, I just noticed I missed the freaking courier package. There was a gauge package back there by the, orange cone right there. I didn't even notice. Hopefully I get. No, I don't. I don't even go that way. Alright, do I? Oh, god damn it, David! Yes! Okay, sweet. Once again, I do not remember this video. This was recorded a long time ago. Like, a week or so. So I do not remember this at all. But yeah, I tried seeing if I could stealth this mission. That's why I have my, Famosophus stealth barrel. But, I just want to give you the differences between stealth and going loud. Now, my stealth video was 12 minutes long. Well, yeah, like technically, yeah, 12 minutes long. I got a message, I'll ignore it. It's not important right now. I'll only answer if it's a phone call. But yeah, the stealth video was 12 minutes long. This one's like 20 minutes long, maybe? I don't know, I can't tell. Yeah, it's maybe like 20 minutes long. But, it's just a huge difference between stealth and a going loud. As it should be, because, you know, there should be a difference. It shouldn't be the same. But the missions are really, 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 like, different. They are not the same at all. I think I get caught here.
This is GenSec Tech Support. Yep. If you have a problem with your radio, please contact us.
Yeah, I already got fucked over. So here the alarm was tripped. So I'm just like, alright, whatever, screw it. We're already here, let's just start going loud. You're supposed to always go after the bank manager first to see if he has anything, like the bank or the access card. He did not. So I'm like, oh, why doesn't he have it? Or I let him move to see if it was underneath him. It wasn't, so I decided to go to his office, and it's right there. I'll steal the money. So by here I start looking around. Or I always go here first. Accidentally pressed melee instead of access. Also, I always play his jacket. I love his sociopath skill, or yeah, perk deck. I don't know why, it's just, I don't know. I would like to have the soak kill one, but I don't have the character yet. I'll be getting him within like the next month or so. But yeah, I always run as a sociopath perk deck, and it's pretty good. I was playing the why do I keep saying goddamn. It's like I can't even talk, but, god damn it, there it is again. Yeah, I was playing the Hoxton breakout mission, and on the second day where you're inside the FBI building, I believe. Yeah, I think it's the FBI, I don't remember. When you're inside the police building, I was just running around with the bat, like, meleeing everyone, and I went from, like, 25% health all the way to 100% within, like, a minute. And, like, I was just going through, just destroying all the enemies. And I was running with the, what was I running with? I recorded it and I was gonna upload it, but I deleted it. Cause like, in the beginning it was really good, but then towards the end it just went all downhill, so I'm like, let's just delete it, it's not worth it. But it was the Sega and the, no, it was a KSG with a slug round, like a modified for 18 accuracy with the KSG, and or the Raven Shotgun, I believe. I think it's the Raven Shotgun. And the Gruber Kurz, otherwise known as the Walter PPK. And I've always loved that gun, and I just remembered why. So the Walter PPK, I'm guessing this is the only reason I like it, but it's the same gun that Sterling Archer from the show Archer uses. So I guess that's why I always use it. Plus it has a lot of ammo. It has less ammo than the Brunelli, but I really don't like the M9. It's not a go-to. And as you could hear, you saw a laser there, and that's from a SWAT turret van. Which, When you stealth it, you don't have to worry about the turret van. When you go loud, yeah, it's a big problem. You do have to worry about it. So I'm taking some more. Yeah, I get some health off this guy. Yep, got a little bit of health off of him. Yeah, there's the van right there. It has the turret on it. So that thing's a huge problem. I think it puts down my teammates a little bit. Got barely any health off of him. And there's two turret vans. There's one right there by the blocked off window, and then there's one outside killing chains right now. So I come try to pick him up. Yeah, when this turret van goes, it gets you down, just like Skulldozer. Which, I've only seen a Skulldozer once. I don't normally play on a Death Wish, so it's not really a problem for me. I'm just here, like, wasting some time. Because this mission does take a while when it's on a loud. And I would say it'd be fun. It is fun stealthing this mission because it adds a worry. Yeah, you see right there, I'm like, oh fuck, there's two turrets on both sides of me, they could get me. Turrets there too. I'm actually surprised that the turret never breaks the, what would that be called? Yeah, I'm surprised that the turret never breaks down the boarded window, but hey, I'm happy it didn't. Although the top of the boarded window you could see, or as you could see earlier, there's a small gap which the turret can fire through. So that's kind of a problem. You see at the top right there, there is a small little gap, but it's big enough for the turret to shoot through. And I think it shoots me like a couple of times towards the end of the mission. Like, I need to track you first before I start shooting. That's what that laser's for. As you can see right here, it starts going on to me. But yeah, I'm gonna start playing around some more in Payday because I've figured out my setup now for less lag. I'm also probably gonna get Goon HUD because Goon HUD or Goon Mod, whatever you want to call it, it's both technically, but I never play with other players. Plus, it only affects you, unless the other players have it as well. But the only reason I want it is so I could get a special mask. Like, I already have the, no, I don't have the Dolph mask yet, actually. I have the Doomweaver pattern. I have the Doomweaver pattern. And I just need to get the Dolph mask, piano black material, and blood red. Because thanks to Denali, or I don't know how to pronounce his name, Denali. Sorry everyone, I butchered your name. I never knew how to say it. But he made an awesome mask about a year or two ago that was Baphomet. And I'm like, that's awesome. But I don't have the material, so I was seeing Goon HUD last night, Goon Mod, whatever. I was seeing it last night, and you could get gauge coins, and you could purchase stuff that you... Instead of having to hope for a lucky drop, you could purchase stuff. So I'm like, I want to buy that just so I can get that mask. Plus, it also has the press F to interact button, so you don't have to hold down F, which is a killer for me. Because my finger, I'm diabetic, I have nerve damage. So, plus I was also in a car accident, so I have bad nerve damage. And holding down F for a long time, especially in missions where you need it, it's so annoying. So I'm like, if I could just... I had Hawkshead for a while, where if you press F, it would interact with the certain objects, but... Now seeing that Goon Mod slash HUD has it, I'm like, okay, I'll purchase that. Plus, you can also change your laser like you could in Hawk's HUD. Because I liked having the rainbow laser, so it's not always green. Just notice there's spray paint up there. But yeah, you could change your laser from green to like rainbow or different colors, and I like that. But Hawk's HUD also had the rainbow headshots where whenever you shot someone, there'd be like a sun flash of rainbow, and it was hilarious. Plus a bunch of different other options that I liked. That I could play without, but I'm just so used to them now that I just prefer them. Here I press the wrong button. Always pressing F instead of E. I don't know why my finger just does. It's a weird thing because they're not right above each other. They're like, they're side by side, but they're not by each other. So it's like, what the hell? So yeah, we're about like halfway through the commentary. As you can see, like, stealth. Stealth is a lot quicker, I would prefer it, but not everything could comes out the way you wish. If I could, I would only stealth missions. But I'm not really that good at stealthing them. The only missions I've been able to stealth is Jewelry Store, but I ECM rushed it, and this one, Bank Heist Cash. Bank Heist Cash was completely by luck. I was not expecting to stealth it, but it just happened, so I'm like, okay, let's go with it. Plus, I've tried stealthing the car heist, and I got through it like halfway, but then the cops come. But I have beaten the mission, so that's not that bad. Plus, when I stealthed it, I don't think I had to wait for the drill. I think I just went straight in. Or no, it's not like that. Sometimes this door will be open, sometimes it'll be closed. That's just completely up to luck, or however the game decides to put it. Let me get some health. Nope, he's dead. So guys, I don't know. I want to start doing more Payday videos. I just have no idea what the hell to do. Oh, the window's broken now. And there's the... I'm not sure if the turret broke it or what, but yep, that boarded up window's gone now. So yeah, now we just wait for the thing. Oh shit, that was an enemy. Apparently I wasn't paying attention here because my character just like, whatever. There's an enemy. As you can tell, I just told the... And I don't know if I call him a hostage or whatever. I just told one of the civilians to get down so I could shoot the cop behind him. Because when you do kill a civilian in this game, you lose different monetary values. It's around $2,500, maybe $3,000. $3,500, I don't know, it changes. But you never want to kill a civilian. And here I am just fucking around. Because I love hearing the Jacket voice. Because I love Hotline Miami, I love Jacket, that's who I always play as. So I was just messing around, listening to the voice. I don't know, there's just something about the voice I like. It's really cool. Here, I'm just trying to see how much longer we have. Hitting it. Because I think the wave is done for a moment. Because not many enemies come in. And mostly every enemy that comes in, either Chains will take care of through this door, or John Wick will take care of from the safe. Here I was like, oh shit, there's too many enemies. I think there's a sniper. Nope. And I don't know why I chose the FAMAS. I could have chose any other gun, honestly, but... Like, I love the FAMAS in real life and in game. I don't know why I just love bullpups. They look amazing, especially the FAMAS, but I could have chose any other gun for this mission, and it would have done the same thing. Like, I could have chose my Car 4 or my Commando 553, but... Or no! I chose the FAMAS. I forgot what it's called in the game. The Clarion? I chose the Clarion rifle because I had a barrel, and I was trying to stealth this mission, but it didn't turn out that good. And knowing it wouldn't turn out that good, that's why I brought the Judge. Because the Judge... The Judge could kill... Alright, so basically, the Judge is one of the most powerful shotguns, I believe? Or it's the most powerful secondary shotgun. If you throw... So, in the game, there are bulldozers. I don't know why I'm, like, having to keep changing the conversation. But it's all revolved around the same thing. There are enemies in the game called bulldozers who are big... Basically, if you play Call of Duty, they're the juggernauts. That's what they are. But they have faceplates, and they have two faceplates on them. And the best way to get rid of them, in my opinion, is to throw a grenade at them... Stun them, then run up on them with the Judge, hit them in the face, and with all five shots, the first shot you get rid of his, or no, like the first shot or two you get rid of their first faceplate, the next two shots you get rid of their second faceplate, and then like the last round you shoot them once in the face and they're gone. Now that'll all change because, ew. It's like a piece of my cereal from earlier in my mouth, ew. But yeah. That'll all change because I'm saving up to buy the RPG, and the RPG will kill a bulldozer in one shot. Shoot it at their feet, their face, wherever. One shot, and the bulldozer is gone. And that'd be... Even if it didn't do that, that'd still be a fun thing to have. Because I just want an RPG, that's fucking awesome. Can you imagine walking into like a huge room, seeing all these enemies, and then just having an RPG kill them all? That's the thing of dreams right there. And I'm halfway there. I need like another 40,000 or so. Maybe 30,000 now. That'll all change when I get Goonhud. Or no. No. When I get Goonhud, I'm only going to use the Efta in Iraq Rainbow Laser. And I'm also only going to use Goon or Gauge Coins just for the mask. After that, I'll earn everything else through money. Like, when it comes to mask, I'll use Gauge Coins. When it comes to everything else, I'll just use money. And the turret van is here. And I think it picks up on me. Yep, it's picking up on me. But thankfully, I have a fast enough character. I'm making sure I don't touch the box, because if I even get within that square, the mission will be over. And it's almost over. We have like 2 minutes left. Here I am. I'm trying to outrun it. Get really close. I stop right here. I'm like, oh, fuck. Wait for my armor to heal. Here, I don't know what the fuck I do. Oh, I throw a Molotov at it like an idiot. Here's where I start using the judge. Because it'll get rid of them. The judge is just way too good. I'm not saying to nerf it, but I'm saying, like, if this were a PvP game, the judge would own PvP. Thank God it's a... I don't know if it'd be player versus environment or something. All I know is that it's more of a co-op game, so you know what? If it helps me win, I'm going for it. Here I help up Chains, because Chains and John Wick, those are the guys who take all the shots. Thankfully, so you know, I could run and do this while they get shot at. That guy had a Renfield 880. Nothing compared to the judge. As you see, I'm just killing enemies with one shot. Plus, this is like an instant reload because I have shotgun skills. Oh, the guy right here. Yep. Shotgun's like too strong. I believe it's like 900, maybe 1,000 damage. Here John Wick goes down. I'm like, sorry Wick, old buddy. I gotta... You keep taking the bullets for me. I'm just gonna come get this. Right here, the turret. The turret has a cooldown, so I'm just like, fuck it. We'll just walk it. We'll let Chains get shot. And then here I'm thinking, like, can I do it? Missed that first shot, get the second. And the third. Place on a doctor back, because if Chains goes down... Because John Wick is already in jail, as you can see here. He's in custody. If Chains goes down, I'm dead. Because there's no way I could go down. Here I am. I don't know why the fuck I threw a Molotov. I could have did this mission faster, but I'm like, whatever, just throw a Molotov. And then I get in just to finish the mission. So yeah. We'll check the personal stats right here. Summary. God, alright. 62 body count, 39 headshots with the Clarion. John Wick was the only person to go down. Oh no, I went down actually. John Wick went down also. Got leveled up to level 65. Got the Thanatos, and I forgot what I get here. I got money, okay. So yeah guys, thanks for watching, that's it.